In this video, I'm going to talk about the engineer scale, and in particular the engineer's 10 scale, and how that relates to the decimal system and whenever you're measuring things using decimal increments. So the picture you see on the screen right now is a detail of an engineer's 10 scale. And the 10 scale is a triangular scale, so it has three sides, and it actually has a total of six different scales on it. But the 10 scale is used by mechanical engineers, usually when they're working in decimal inches. So you can see there's a dimension here of 1.5 inches, and 2.75 inches would be from the 0 to the 2.75 would be out here, and then 3.125, and I'm going to get more into those in a minute, but the scale begins at 0, and this is 1 inch, 2 inches, 3 inches, and then we can count the increments that it's marked on here, and those increments are 1/10 of an inch. So let's look at this dimension right here, 3.125, which relates to this dimension that we have right down here on our scale. And so the first number to the left of this decimal point that we have right here are the whole inches. So 3 full inches is what we're looking at here, and then a part of another inch for in total for the length. So the next thing to focus on here is the decimal point, because everything to the right of the decimal point is the fractional part of the measurement, and that's actually broken down into a placeholder. The first placeholder to the right of the decimal point is inches and tenths of an inch. The second placeholder holds hundredths of an inch, and the third placeholder holds thousandths of an inch. So the way we would read this dimension right here, we might call it 3.125, or we might say 3 125,000ths of an inch. So 125 is what we're seeing here, and the last digit that we're seeing over here is in the thousandths place. So that's why I'm saying we could call this 3 125,000ths of an inch. So here's a detail of 2 inches broken into 10 equal increments. So each of these increments that we're seeing, like here and here and here and here, is 1/10 of an inch apart. So if we start at 0 and we count 5 of those, we get to this point right here, we would say that we are at 0.5 inches, which would be 5/10 of an inch. If we only count one increment, we would say we're at 0.1, and 0.1 represents 1/10 of an inch, and would be written out as 0.1 instead of 1/10, but it's still the same thing. Now on this slide, what I did was I took the same 2-inch scale that I had in the previous slide, and I still have the tenths, which are the larger, the longer numbers here, so each of those represents 1/10 of an inch all the way across. And then between each of those tenths, I added 10 more equally spaced marks. And what that does by dividing the tenths into 10 places is each of these small marks represents 1/100 of an inch. All right, so if we start at the 0 over here and we go 1/10, 2/10, 3/10, 4/10, 5/10, we're at the 0.5, that's where we're seeing this 0.5 right here. But then I went over 2 more of those smaller marks, which represent, like I said, 1/100 of an inch. So we have 2/100, which is right here. So what we would say about this is that the value for that is 0.52. Some people say 0.52. But another way to say it would be that that's 52 1/100 of an inch. Now, if we look at our 1/10 measurement that we have right here, on the previous sheet, all we said was 0.1, but now, because we're measuring in hundredths of an inch, we add a 0 over here, and so what we would call this dimension here, or this value here, is 10 one-hundredths of an inch. Okay, now we're going to divide those hundredths into 10 places, and each one of those will represent a thousandth of an inch. So here's how it starts. I took a tenth of an inch, which is the distance from this increment to this increment here, and then I magnified it and I divided it by 10. So each of these longer marks you're seeing right here is a hundredth of an inch. So if you look up here, the distance between this mark and this mark is represented right here as 0.01. And so it says this is a hundredth of an inch and 0.01 would be a hundredth of an inch, but there's an extra zero back here, which I'll get to in just a second. So then in my magnified view of this 1/10 inch that I have up here, between each of these increments with the longer lines right there, which represent a hundredth of an inch, I divided that into 10 more equal parts, which actually represent 1/1000th of an inch. So the distance between every two of these marks that are closer together, which we're seeing right here, that distance is actually 1/1000th of an inch. And we would write that as 0.001, and that would represent 1/1000th of an inch, because remember, it's tenths, hundredths, thousandths of an inch. Now I want to come back up here and go back to this view. So imagine that we add that zero into the thousandths place on this, because really the distance between this increment and this increment is 10/1000ths. So a machinist would look at this, and instead of calling that 1/100th of an inch, because machinist machines, the manufacturing equipment that they use, the fundamental unit of measurement is usually 1/1000th of an inch. So they sort of think in 1/1000th of an inch increments. So they would look at this same number right here of 0.010, and they would call that 10/1000ths of an inch. And in fact, they wouldn't even say the thousandths, they would call this 10 thou. Okay, so that term thou is used when they're referring to 1/1000th of an inch. So if we come back down here and we look at our 0.001, a machinist would refer to this as 1 thou. Okay, and that's important for you to know when you're talking about dimensioning and tolerancing and things that we'll be studying later in this class. Now, 1 thou is also called a mil, M-I-L, but in machine shops, I'm a lot more, my experience is that it's a lot more common for people to refer to that as 1 thou. So what if you took 1/1000th of an inch and divided it into 10 parts? You would be talking really small increments, and actually what you would have at that point is 1/10,000th of an inch. And if you wrote 1/10,000th, you would write 0.0001. And so here's what you have. Here's your tenths place, here's your hundredths, here's your thousandths place. And so this guy right here, the fourth place over, would actually become 10,000th. Now, machinist, just like they have a word for 1/1000th, what they call a thou, a machinist refers to a 10,000th of an inch as a tenth, all right? And so what I want you to know is that you don't want to confuse a 10,000th of an inch, which a machinist may be referring to as a tenth, with 1/10th of an inch, okay? So machinists refer to things a little bit differently than people in the office may. And maybe not, but I'm just wanting to make sure that you're aware of that difference. So here's kind of a summary. If we have 0.1, that would be in the tenths place, we have a 1, so that would be 1/10th of an inch. If it's written as 0.10, because we've got a tenth and a hundredth placeholder, we would say that's 10/100ths of an inch. And if the same dimension were written as 0.100, we would have 100/1000ths of an inch. All right. Now, if we have 0.01, that represents 1/100th of an inch, because there's a 1 in the hundredths place. And if we have 0.001, where we have a 1 in the thousandths place right here, that would represent 1/1000th of an inch. And remember that in the vernacular of machinist, and by that we mean the way they talk about things, the way they use language in the machine shop, they refer to 1/1000th of an inch as 1 thou. So over here, if you have a dimension written as 0.010, a machinist would call that 10 thou, because there's a 0 in the thousandths place, so they look in the hundredths place, and together they see that there are 10. So kind of following that logic, if we have a number that's written 0.325, we might say that that's 325 thousandths. So 325, and the 5 is in the thousandths, or if you're a machinist, you might say 325 thou. Now, I was looking for something that's about 1 inch in size, and it turns out that in my research, I found out that a quarter has a diameter of 0.955 inches. So it's not quite 1 inch. And if you subtract 0.955 from 1.000, you would actually see that what you would have left is a 0.045. And so we know now that 0.045 is 45 thousandths of an inch. That's how much that a quarter's diameter is shy of being a full inch in diameter. All right, so the last thing I want to show you is 0.0001. So we've got a tenths, a hundredths, a thousandths, and a 10,000th. So that is 1/10,000th of an inch, which a machinist might refer to as 1/10. But we don't want to confuse that with what's actually 1/10th of an inch. All right, so I hope this clears up a little bit about the decimal system. And so I'm going to go all the way back to that first slide I had of the engineer's 10 scale. So now we can see we have 1 5/10 on this dimension here. On this dimension here, we have 2 75/100 of an inch. And up here, we have 3 125/1000 of an inch. And that is how a mechanical engineer or a mechanical drafter might use the engineer's 10 scale.